Bring Me the Horizon, post-human, survival horror. I will say one thing, this is exactly what I fucking wanted. So sometime last year, Bring Me the Horizon announced that they were going to be releasing EPs from now on. Instead of doing the full album thing where they go away for ages and write a full album, they all decided that they didn't like doing that process anymore and they just wanted to start releasing EPs, which means more music for us, more music releasing for them, and it just works out for everybody in a really nice way, and I really like this. I think this is a really cool way, because I don't want to go a few years without any new Bring Me the Horizon music, and this year has delivered some fucking amazing music, especially by this band. I've been so excited for this to come out, and it does not disappoint. Honestly, it does not disappoint at all. I don't even know where to start with this review, so I'm just going to go through all the tracks on it. So if you've watched this channel before, or you know me, you know that Bring Me the Horizon are my absolute number one favourite band in the world, and I will never stop talking about them. I can't imagine my life without this band. They mean so much more to me than any other band, any other piece of music I've ever heard. So it'd be easy for me to say, yeah, this is amazing, it's them, of course it's amazing, but that, I don't want that to be the case. I want to like give it a fair review, a fair judgement. This is my absolute honest opinion of it, and obviously that is going to be influenced a bit because I'm a fan of them. If you're not a fan of Bring Me the Horizon, I don't really know why you're watching this video, but if you're checking out the new EP, then all the better, I guess. So we'll start with the first song that we got for this EP, all the way back in November last year, Ludens. Ludens was a song that Bring Me the Horizon wrote for the game Death Stranding, and they weren't even sure if it was going to get featured, and it did get featured on the game, and it is on the game, so if you have played Death Stranding, and you've heard Ludens, I've never played this game, but I know kind of where the song shows up in it. They did release a music video for this song as well, and it kind of features scenes from the game as well as Bring Me the Horizon in this as well. This song has been very overplayed for me in the last year, I will say that. I'm very, very used to this song. I don't even think of this song as like on the EP, but then I realise, oh yeah, Ludens is on the EP, because it's just been out for so much longer than all the other songs on this. It is a banging single, it's just a bit overplayed for me now, but I do absolutely love it. Then we had months and months of nothing from the band. They started posting videos on their YouTube of them making this song, and we didn't know the name of the song for a while. Then it became clear that the song's name was Parasite Eve when they were teasing it fully. It's probably my most played song of 2020, and I especially can't wait to hear this one live. I think it'd be really cool as an opening song, and I feel like there's a big chance that they'll start opening the stage with this song. The third song that came out for Posthuman is a song that features one of my favourite artists from 2020, which is Youngblood. Youngblood is someone that I never listened to before this year, really. I tried listening to him last year briefly, but I just remember not really being a fan, and then I've really gotten into him this year, and I really do enjoy his music, but this song in particular, he absolutely kills it. He fits so well with Bring Me the Horizon's vibe as well, and the song is called Obey. It's just awesome. I think Youngblood compliments Ollie, and Ollie compliments Youngblood in such a way that just, I want to hear more with those two together. I think it's safe to say that there'll definitely be another collab in the future. Youngblood's so fucking cool and different, and that's exactly what Bring the Horizon need. What he stands for, what he sings about, it all just fits in with Bring Me's vibe so much, and I really would like another collaboration in future with these two. Earlier this week we got Teardrops, fourth release from the EP. It's an absolutely beautiful song and it does not disappoint. I was so ready for this. Been a few weeks of constantly replaying Ludens and Parasite Eve and Obey. There's a great message in the song. It's all about hating your thoughts in your own head, and that is me. That is literally me, and I think that relates to so many people this year especially. There's a line in it that just makes perfect sense. It's so simple, everything is so fucked, and that's in the chorus, and It has so much meaning this year especially, because everything is fucked due to Corona and everything is just so different, and that's given us so much more time to be trapped in our own heads, and this song addresses that. So we've got Dear Diary, which is completely what I did not expect. It's gonna shock everybody. I think this one's gonna shock everybody. It sounds like a mix of Sam Paternal, There Is A Hell, dare I say Suicide Season. The screams and the growls from Ollie in this song are powerful as fuck. The parts of this song, he sounds like he's back in his young 20s in his deathcore emo phase, and I love that. I think that's awesome. I think that's a great like little, it gives off so many vibes from the past albums, and I think everybody listening to this who really likes old Bring Me and kind of doesn't really enjoy the newer Bring Me is going to really appreciate this song. Itch for a Cure is sort of an interlude but also works as an intro for Kingslayer. Baby Metal are in this little bit of music as well as in Kingslayer. I don't really think it's an official interlude, but I'm going to call it one because it kind of sounds like one and it's its own separate thing to Kingslayer, so Kingslayer is probably the most unexpected thing on the album for me. I don't really listen to Baby Metal, but I do like a few songs by them. This song is just heavy, it's catchy, it's exactly what we all wanted, it really is. And Baby Metal sound great on this as well, so props to them. You can tell that Jordan Fish has had a big part in this song especially, and the mixing in this is so fucking good. so much talent. There's so much talent from everyone in this, everyone involved in this. And 1x1 or 1&1 or 1x1, whatever you want to call it. I'm not really sure what the exact name for it is yet. I'm sure we'll find out eventually. This feats Nova Twins. Again, it's super catchy, super catchy. I've not really memorized the lyrics from it yet because I've not heard it that many times, but I'm really glad that I like this one as well, because this was the one that I was kind of worried about because I don't know who Nova Twins are. Something that Bring the Horizon have started doing since Ammo is collaborating with pop artists and artists that are very relevant, which is a really smart move, to be honest. I think they're opening the doors for a whole new era of rock and heavy bands collaborating with pop people and rappers and indie artists. They've collabed with Halsey, Grimes and Youngblood and Nova Twins. I will admit it does work really well, and I think it's opened up a whole new generation and a new era of music where it can all be combined into one. You don't just have to like one genre of music. Finally, One Day the Only Butterflies Left Will Be in Your Chest as You March Towards Your Death, featuring Amy Lee. Amy Lee is the singer of the band Evanescence, if you didn't know that, but I'm pretty sure everyone knows that. Her voice is easily one of the most powerful female voices out there ever in existence, I think. She's great, she's super talented. Evanescence aren't the band that I've ever been a massive fan of, but I do know their most well-known singles and I enjoy them. I don't think there's anyone who doesn't know their song Bring Me To Life as well. This song feels like an Evanescence song featuring Ollie Sykes. It does feel like that. It's so calm, it's perfect for Evanescence's vibe. It completely works, it just doesn't really... I don't think it fits in with the rest of the EP, which is pretty much what Ammo was like. That was all over the place with different kinds of sounds, which... nothing wrong with that at all. I enjoy how it all... it works together, so in a way it does work, I guess, but... because most of this EP is so heavy, and then you get this one. This song doesn't really have a massive build-up. It is calm all the way through. And I was expecting a sort of build-up towards the end, and it kind of does that, but it kind of just cuts off then. It doesn't really go into a big, you know, a big breakdown or anything. But it does work, and I think Ollie and Amy's vocals together sound really awesome. There's parts where they're singing on their own and parts where they both sing together, and it really does sound cool, and I really like the idea of them collabing with these artists that they would never think. You'd never think that Bring Me The Horizon would collab with Amy Lee from Evanescence. I think that there's going to be more of this kind of thing where they collab with artists that you wouldn't expect them to, and I'm all for it. I really am. Honestly, if I could give my one line best review of this EP, I would say it was a mix of all of Bring Me The Horizon's albums into one set of songs, because there's aspects from all of them in there. I think this is a great way for them to release something, because it's for everyone, it's for all the fans, and I think every fan of Bring Me New and Old will enjoy at least a couple of songs on this EP, and that's really good. The creativity and the diversity and the lengths that this band goes to is... I'll never understand how once that deathcore band that gradually grew over time and experimented to become this headline-worthy, arena-filling band. I want to know what you guys think about Posthuman. Let me know what you think about it down in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video and you like the EP, then please remember to smash the like button down below. You can also subscribe to me at the end of this video or down below. I've got all my social medias as well if you want to check them out. I've got Instagram, Twitter and Facebook all down there. All the links are in there if you want to go check them out. If you're brand new to my channel, then I do vlogs, I do music-related videos, and mainly festival-related content. If you're into festivals and concerts, and if you like to watch somebody talking about festivals and festival lineups especially, then subscribe, please, because that is what we do here. I try and do it as frequently as possible. It's a bit hard this year because of COVID, but we'll get in there. And thank you so much for watching this video, guys, and I'll be back with another one real soon. I'm running out of teardrops.